In this section, we're going to put together the QromaScan LightBox and show you how to set up the QromaScan SlideBox to set up slides and negatives. There are three different ways that you can use to power the QromaScan LightBox. The first is to use the included 9-volt adapter that came with the LightBox. Now, this is great if you're gone somewhere and you don't have access to a USB plug or a power outlet. The second way is to use a standard household DC adapter. Now, this didn't come with the QromaScan LightBox, but you can buy them on Amazon for less than $10. As long as it says it's 12 volt and it has a standard DC tip, it should work. Finally, the most versatile way to power the LightBox is to use the QromaScan USB adapter, which will allow you to use any USB outlet as a power source for the LightBox. You can use a variety of different USB outlets to power the LightBox, including your iPhone charger, a port on your computer, or my favorite, which is a rechargeable USB power bank. Okay, let's put together the QromaScan LightBox. I take it out of the box and I like to rotate it so that the spine is on my left so I can set the brace arm easier, which I grab and guide right into the slot. Next, I guide the top flap down into position. When I'm done, everything should be lined up and should look like this. I'm going to use the QromaScan USB adapter and a battery pack to power the lights. You can pick these up on Amazon for about $10, and this one has a built-in solar panel and two USB ports. I'm going to use the second USB port to charge my iPhone, so it will slow down the drain on my battery as I use the camera. Next, I'll slide my iPhone right along this edge created by the tab until it reaches the foam pad and make sure that the phone is firmly in the corner. One thing I should mention is to turn off any strong overhead or side lights. QromaScan works best when it supplies the light. Now, if you're in a place where you can't control the lighting, here's a tip. Use the LightBox cover to seal off the left side of the LightBox. This is the side that's most sensitive to light bleed, and this is an effective way to minimize it.